After passing the preliminary selection for receiving a free cochlear implant from various programs, the patient is directed to the hospital for further tests and preparation for the surgery. Investigations. An investigation is needed to assess the patient's condition and his surgical fitness. The patient will undergo auditory testing with auditory brainstem response, known as ABR, audiometry, and audio steady state response, known as ASSR, to assess the degree of hearing loss. Imaging of the middle and inner ear is done with a CT scan, while the cochlear and auditory nerve are evaluated with MRI. Pediatricians need to conduct further evaluation to rule out associated disorders or syndromes. Patients may be discussed in a multidisciplinary team meeting to finalize the patient's eligibility for a cochlear implant. Then, if deemed eligible, the patient and attendants meet up with audiologists, speech therapists, and clinical psychologists for counseling, setting realistic expectations, and assessing motivation for regular speech therapy and follow-up. Surgery. In an anatomically normal ear, the surgery may take around 2 hours. After the patient is given general anesthesia and is positioned accordingly, the first step is to pull the ear forward. Then, an incision is made behind the ear. The outermost tissues are retracted until the mastoid bone can be accessed. This is called the transmastoid approach. At the beginning, the superior, posterior part of the opening is parted using the subperiosteal elevator to create the pocket to fit the implant's receiver. The surgeons put the receiver template inside to ensure that the pocket is adequate. Next, the mastoid bone is drilled. Suction and irrigation are deployed to prevent tissue damage. The drilling continues until the short process of the incus and semicircular canal are visible. After that, the surgeons locate the facial nerve and chorda tympani and preserve it. Using posterior tympanotomy, the facial recess between them is drilled until the round window can be accessed. The round window is the hole where the electrode will be inserted through the scarlet tympani until it reaches the end of the cochlea. If the round window is obstructed or is not facing the intended direction, bone cochleostomy or cutting a part of the cochlea must be performed. The receiver is put on the opening and the electrode is inserted as slowly as possible to prevent damage to the cochlea. Once the electrode is in place, its position and integrity is further confirmed by intraoperative telemetry. Some soft tissue, such as pieces of fat or biocompatible gel, is placed around the electrode and round window opening to prevent them from moving too much. The retracted fascia and skin are then closed in layers. Sutures or surgical staples are used to close the wound. Postoperatively, an X-ray of the skull may be done to confirm that the electrodes have not been displaced. After the anesthesia wears off, there are still a few last steps before hearing the sound of the world, and that will be discussed in the next video. Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content. Yeah.